Involving the community and bringing new perspectives to a controversial development on the peninsula. That's the goal of the Union Pier Community Advisory Council, which met for the first time last night.
Hosted by the Riley Center for Livable Communities, the council was created after the previous Union Pier plans were put on hold after community reactions and feedback.
Our Emily Johnson met with members of council last night and tells us more about exactly how the process all works.
With a packed room of over 60 people, the council is made up of a diverse community representatives who bring different expertise and perspectives to the table. One goal of the council is for each person to represent groups, communities, or organizations that are directly impacted by the development of Union Pier. Some in attendance last night included preservation and sustainability organizations, realtors, architects, Charleston museums, and neighborhood representatives. Information from groups will be used in new plans and for all organizations involved in the planning process. With the lack of community input being a concern in the previous plans, the council is expected to receive updates throughout the development and planning phases.
Well, I would just hope that, you know, this committee is able to bring forth a vision for how the Union Pier project can look. And we want to make sure that we are bringing the voices of our community to the table as that planning process continues.
The council will continue to meet to hear updates and share additional opinions. Their work will continue through the summer of this year. Reporting in Charleston, Emily Johnson, Live 5 News.
Public workshops will also be held this month, January 24th from 4 to 7 p.m. and January 25th from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m.
The location is yet to be determined, but updates can be found on the Union Pier website, and that link is under this story on Live5News.com.